Hi everyone, so today I have a quick resin charm update for you, so let's get started. So first I have this little gingerbread guy, and I painted him as Gingy from Shrek. Then I have these kind of roundish charms, and they originally came out matte from the mold, but then after glazing they got shiny again. So here's the little Rilakkuma with a cake and sun star sprinkles and blue glitter on the back. Then there's a Rilakkuma picnic one with Rilakkuma and Karoritori and some gold glitter. Then I have this other Rilakkuma with a large cake, and these are actually four different stickers. There's the cake, the bow, and Rilakkuma with Karoritori. And then there's sprinkles and red glitter on the back. And then I have this little Rilakkuma picnic one with a burger and a little Karoritori, and then grass and some blue glitter for the sky. Then I have this little Stitch one, and I put all blue sprinkles in there. So there's some star sprinkles, some dark and light blue sprinkles, and blue glitter on the back. And I have this little Cinnamoroll one, and it's actually quite huge because I didn't know how deep the mold was initially, but I really do like it, and I really love the sticker in it. And I have this little SpongeBob one with white sprinkles, kind of for like sea bubbles, and blue glitter on the back. Then I have these two Hello Kitty ones, so there's this little one here, and then this little one. And this one has like pink and white glitter on the back, and my white glitter has these like green and blue sparkles in it, so it's really pretty. Then I have this little star one, and it's just all gold glitter, so I'm going to put a little face on it to make it look like the Mario star. Then I have this little Rilakkuma one with some green glitter on the back. I have this Baby Pooh one, and I just think the sticker is really adorable, so it has red glitter on the back. Then I have these two Berry Puppy ones. So first there's this one with some pastel rainbow sprinkles and some purple glitter on the back, and that's the sticker. And then this one is the other one, and it kind of reminds me of Christmas and a strawberry for some reason as well. So I think it's really pretty, and you can see the two layers of how I make my resin, which I'll have a tutorial on it very very soon. Then I made two other Cinnamoroll charms. So first there's this little one with the mocha Cinnamoroll, and it has gold glitter on the back. And then I have this little blue one with a little heart. Next, I have this Sentimental Circus charm, and it has some holographic balloon confetti in the back and some purple glitter. Then I have two Mamagoma ones. So first there's this one, and I know you can see scratches on the back. That was from when I was polishing the sides off, and my buffing wheel wouldn't do the job right. So if anyone knows a way to kind of get rid of the scratches, please, please let me know, because this is a clear charm and they're very visible, and I want to correct that. And I actually made this one for my boyfriend because he just fell in love with the sticker and he wanted me to make him that charm. And then I made one that I'm going to put on my keys, which is absolutely tiny. It's even smaller than my nail, and it's just a little heart with a little holographic Mamagoma, and I put some teeny tiny bubbles inside. I don't know if you can see them, just so that it looks like he's in the water. And then it's just clear on the back. And then last but not least, I made a whole bunch of Rilakkuma charms from a new mold that I got from One Stand at One. So the first two are these little tiny chocolates, and they have Rilakkuma written on them, which I painted black, and they're just plain chocolates. I still have to glaze these and get rid of the matte sides from the buffing. Then there are these two little chocolates, and one is Rila Kuma, one is Karila Kuma. That one's painted with black and that one with brown. And then lastly, I have this little Rila Kuma head, which I absolutely love. And I painted his ears yellow and his facial details there with black and white paint. And it's just all black or brown resin that I dyed. And that'll be in my tutorial as well. So these are all the charms I made. I hope you like them. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye bye.